And Tuesday, we walked into a new season. We walked into the season of spring. And in springtime, people like to plant their gardens or plant flowers. So they go get the seeds. The title of today's message is, You Are a Seed of Christ. In John 12:24 of the NIV version, Jesus says, Unless a kernel of wheat falls to the ground and dies, it remains a single seed. But if it dies, it produces several seeds. When Jesus died on the cross, he produced several seeds in you and I. When we became a part of the body of Christ, we became a seed of Christ. When I looked up the definition of what a seed is a copy of the plant from which it comes or from the thing of which it comes. So therefore, when we became a part of the body of Christ, we became a copy of whom we came from, a copy of Jesus Christ. Because Jesus is living down inside of us, allowing us to be able to grow and be cultivated and become more like him, to look more like him. That is our goal, is to die to self and to surrender to Christ and to be the seed so that he can blossom and grow us to be what we need to be. In order for a seed to germinate properly, to grow properly, it needs a few things. It needs light, it needs water, it needs the right soil, time, and temperature. Well, I'm here to tell you today that God is the light that shines down on you and allows you to grow in whatever area it is that you need growth. That the water is given to us through the Holy Spirit. The water comes down into us and cultivates and fills us up in any area that we need. The soil is the place that God has planted us in. So some of us may be in a situation right now, we may be in a location right now where we may not quite be able to understand, but that's your soil. That's what's holding you in place because God's doing some things in your life. And temperature. You know, we go through trials and tribulations where the temperature might go up or it might decrease. But you got to realize those temperatures is just making you what you need to become. And time is the process where we're growing, the process where our buds are coming out, the process where eventually we come up out of that soil of which we've been in and what we've been lying dormant in. We come up out of that because God has us growing constantly and becoming more like him constantly and trying to be identical to him constantly. And even though we're not worthy, we are still seeds of Christ because he died on the cross, making it to where he wasn't the single seed, but he produced several, so that we can look like him and try to walk like him and try his best to live our life according to what his word says. So the timing is the process. The soil is the place he has us. The water is the Holy Spirit within us continually filling us. The light is God because he sent his son, Jesus. And the temperature are the trials that we go through. But I'm here to encourage you because you, since you are a seed of Christ, have been planted by him and you're going to come out beautiful. You're going to come out something like never before. You are going to blossom and sprout and bloom into something that God has called you to be. And when the world sees you, and when the things that come out of the situations that you've gone through, they will see the glory of God shining right about you. I hope you were blessed by this message. Don't let anyone diminish you. You are going to come out beautiful. You are going to blossom. You are going to sprout forth. Be blessed and have an amazing Friday, and I will see you next week.